Okay, I'm being told we can get started. So start with good afternoon, DTE. I know we've got a bunch of people here on the turbine deck here at Rouge. Also, we've got quite a few joining us virtually. We'd also like to thank Mayor Bowdler for joining us today. Been a great partner over the years. He's here to speak to us to kind of as we go through and actually mark this historic event for us. Basically, we just want to thank all of you for being here today and participating with this with us. Also joining us today, we've got our chairman and CEO, Jerry Norcia. We've also got our president and COO of DT Electric, Trevor Lauer, senior vice president of fossil generation, Ben Felton, and we've got River Rouge as plant manager, Nader Rajabian, that'll be speaking also. My name's Brian Kincaid. I'm the director of the South and Central area here for DTE. As a lot of you know, I've worked here since basically 2005, or been a part of this area off and on since 2005. So this plant actually has a very, very special place for me. It's where I started. Actually, my first year here, I started as a contractor. Lynette kicked me out of the plant for a project that we were doing. She told me I'd worked too many hours here on site, which is actually a testament to the people that are here. You know, everybody is, it's got a long history of everybody pulling together and doing a lot of incredible things as we go through. Now, as we move forward, because of COVID, it's a little bit different setup. Haven't been able to have a big shindig like we normally would out in the parking lot to allow people to come in and celebrate. So we're having to do a little bit different. So we've got a number of people here on the turbine deck with us. Also, I'd like to thank all the employees and retirees that are joining us online to celebrate this with us. And we do want to thank everybody for their contributions over the years. This plant has been a big part of DTE. I know back when I was the production manager here in 1959, there was actually a postcard. I wasn't a production manager in 1959, but when I was the production manager, on the plant manager's desk, there was a postcard from 1959. It was on Brian Rice's conference table in his office. And at that point, River Rouge was actually the largest power plant in the country. And so I know on the sign over his, it talks about the small and mighty River Rouge, but at one time in its history, it was the largest plant in the country. So as we get into this today, we do want to take you back down memory lane a little bit. So if I can direct everybody to the monitors, we're actually going to start with a video before I introduce Jerry. So take it away.
Rouge was very important to the continued development of the industrial world in Southwest Detroit and was a key component for the Great Lakes Steel Facility. But you put it in context then with the development of both Trenton on the high pressure units and Trenton 9 and then also St. Clair 7 and then shortly thereafter Monroe. Rouge had its place then and it still did up until the past couple of years. You know, now it is of that design-based end of life and it's time to appropriately shut it down and move through decommissioning.
River Rouge Unit 1, at the time it was built, it was the first boiler that had superheated steam above 1,000 degrees, so it was a scientific first at the time. The power plant had three boilers from three different manufacturers. It had three turbines from three different manufacturers. They fired oil, coal, gas, industrial waste gases, natural gas, blast furnace gas, coke oven gas. That plant had all the equipment that you would bump into in your career. You would find it at River Rouge. It was a great training ground. And because of that, there's people from Rouge all over the company working in power plants and our leaders all throughout the company.
Many people throughout the fleet started here. They cut their teeth here at Rouge. They have footprints here at Rouge. And we're all a part of that.
A lot of places have, you know, strict walls and maintenance and ops and tech. Not here. It was like, you know, we're a group, we're a family, we need to get something done, we just go do it.
Some of the brightest, most talented folks you could ever want to work with. Because of the diversity of the people, so we had diversity of ideas, and we had a diversity in the plant of all kinds of different equipment. You had to know how to run everything if you were going to work at Rouge.
My time at DTE's River Rouge Power Plant was most likely the best years of my career, and it was all because of the people. We had important work to do, but we did it together in a fun and productive way.
Most of us like to think there's something in the water here, because once you get to River Rouge, It doesn't matter what your title is. It doesn't matter what your job function is. If you want to be successful here, if you want to stay here, you have to be willing to pitch in and to help the next person out.
Maybe because it's smaller, maybe it's because of the mix of people. Maybe it's because the unit itself is far more manual, so everyone has to rely on each other more. I don't know, but it's a much more friendly place, and it's much more like family.
A blackout is obviously an event that stands out. It was one of our worst days, but one of our best days. And that really brought together us, Plant, River Rouge as a group, to bring the plant back to life, and then to bring the electrical system back to life.
I was passing up an exit where I could get to Rouge, and I said, let me stop in there and see if they need a hand. When I got to that plant, everybody was showing up, just like me.
We all got together and got the plant back online within, I think it was 18 hours.
So that can-do attitude is something that I think that kind of became a trademark for us here at River Rouge.
I'd like people to remember River Rouge as a place where it did its part in the history of our area.
It's going to be an emotional day for me. And not only me, many of us is going to be emotional. And then it's going to be hard to just walk away, just okay, be done with this plan, be going to a different phase. What makes the plant unique is the interaction with the employee. Equipment is there. Equipment doesn't talk back, doesn't say anything. We just have to fix it. And just interaction with the employee to fix that piece of equipment, we're going to miss.
When I think back, you know, I would just hope that they think of how small but mighty this plant was and how mighty the people that worked at this plant were.
All right, with that, welcome Jerry Norcia. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. What a great video. Just tremendous history here. And really tells the story of the great people of River Rouge. As Nader said, it's no doubt an emotional day for everyone here. Standing in front of me right now, and all the people that are online, the many generations that work here, and I get it. This has become your second home and also part of your family by working together. This plant has served us well, but we know that technology has changed and what our customers want has started to evolve. So we've come to this day where this plant will retire, has retired, and I know how hard this can be. You know, I've walked through this plant and some of our other plants, and you know, you see pictures on the wall of families and multi-generations that have worked at a plant like this to make this plant successful, to make DTE successful. So it's really hard to say goodbye to a plant like this. For 65 years, this plant stood proudly delivering safe, reliable, and affordable power to our customers, and really helping to power Southeast Michigan. A little background on what led up to the plant being built. Following World War II, the country began an economic boom that brought prosperity to almost every aspect of American life. High levels of automobile manufacturing in Detroit and Southeast Michigan, along with additional customers and increased energy use, resulted in new generation demands across our company's business. So in 1954, to meet that demand, placed on the existing 5 coal-fired power plants in the Detroit Edison fleet, construction began on the River Rouge Power Plant. This plant, went into service in 1957 with 2 generating units of 260 megawatts each. At the time, these generating units were the largest in the world and one of the smallest plants in a coal-fired fleet. As Michigan's need for electricity grew over the decades, our employees at River Rouge worked together to serve our customers and communities as really an engine of progress for Southeast Michigan. I could not be more proud of the thousands of people, both past and present, who have walked through the doors of this plant and called River Rouge their home. It is clear that one thing has remained consistent throughout the years is the sense of family that has united employees throughout the decades at this plant and throughout our company. As our industry continues to evolve, and we move into the next evolution of power generation, the people who have been that backbone of the small but mighty River Rouge will always be in our hearts and minds, and they have our company's gratitude. For those of you who are active employees and retirees of DTE, I want to tell you that the future of DTE is very bright. Even though this is a mixed emotion event, we have a lot in front of us as a company, and we have a lot more memories to create together and a lot of history to build together. So those of you who are still active, let's make our retirees and our other partners in the community proud of what we will do as DTE employees into the future. So it is great, with great pride, that I say thank you for your commitment to this plant, the community, our company, but most of all to each other. Thank you.
What I can tell from Rouge is it's a different kind of neighborhood than every other plant. When I move from here, I think it's gonna be a bit like moving away from home. Because it's not just the people, and it's not just the place, but it's the memories and everything you guys have done together.
Well, hello everyone, and wow, what a day to feel pride to be an employee or a retiree of DTE standing here. I'm really enjoying hearing all the stories. That video was fantastic. I actually thought Brian Rice might shed a tear at one point as we were in the video. When I joined DTE in 2005, the first power plant I came to was here at River Rouge. And my distinct memory of coming to River Rouge is how the team talked about our employees. They talked about safety. We talked about continuous improvement. But we spent a lot of time talking about those issues. And I have to digress for a second. The reason why I came to River Rouge is I had just joined the company. And I was in the elevator and I met Lynette Dowler. And a month into my career, Lynette said, you should come down to River Rouge. And I wore this exact same coat 16 years ago when I came to River Rouge. And when I got here, Lynette said, what are you doing? You can't wear a coat like that in the power plant. Thank you, Lynette, I appreciate it. I've had a lot of opportunities to be here since then. And the one thing that I'll say is it holds true still. Our employees care so much about each other. Safety for our employees. Great operations, just continuously improving. I was here 3 weeks ago, and the same things I saw 16 years ago are the same things that you see at this plant today. The other thing that makes me really proud when I think about what's happened here at River Rouge is our employees and the heart that our employees have and the way that they've tirelessly given back to the communities that we get to live and serve in, right? And I'll give you a couple examples of the volunteering activities that they've done that I think really helped the community of River Rouge. Back in 2016, we had a massive outage on the electricity system, and our employees here at River Rouge and a series of other ones, it was over 100 degrees with the heat index, delivered over 1,000 cases of water across Metro Detroit to help a lot of people that didn't have power and didn't have air conditioning. In 2020, the DTE Foundation partnered with Gleaners, and they donated 250 boxes of food that were delivered by the employees here at River Rouge to people that were in River Rouge that were facing food insecurity, right? Just a great thing to do. Our power plant employees volunteer every year to come and plant flowers and clean. The mayor was sharing with me the story about how they clean and beautify around City Hall, and he was talking about how the employees of River Rouge do the hard work, right? Others get to come in and do the beauty work, but our employees do all the hard work. Every year at Christmas time, our employees get together and they get 300 gifts, they wrap 300 gifts, and they donate them to needy children through a program called No Kids Without Christmas. So, you know, Jerry mentioned small but mighty. Brian mentioned small but mighty. This team is anything but small but mighty. As they give back to the community, it's just an example I think we can all take on what we should do. So I want to thank everybody. I want to thank the employees. I'll echo what Jerry said for the retirees. You've done such a great job, not only making this a wonderful asset for our customers, but making us so proud to have a partnership with the City of River Rouge. And with that, I'd like to invite Mayor Bowdler up to say a few words and thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Trevor. You know, when I'm here, and I've been here 8 years ago, but all through my career, the employees from River Rouge Power Plant have always stepped forward. So seeing that video, that was part of the water. There's something in the water down here that makes everybody so nice. So it's a real honor to be here on this historical day today. Back in the 1950s as a boy, I remember watching this plant take shape on the banks of the Detroit River. After school, me and my friends would come over here and look at the site in awe. It was going to be part to live in this community as this type of landmark took shape. Often we would spend our afternoons watching the ships unload coal at the plant or seeing the rail cars arrive to the head of the plant burn with coal. To watch industrial spur up in River Rouge was an incredible and exciting experience as a youth. At that time, the auto industry was booming in Detroit and River Rouge. Workers from nearby factories like DTE River Rouge Power Plant would catch the bus to and from work or drive down West Jefferson Avenue, stopping at local stores, picking up cakes at Shear's Bakery or hardware at Lozon's Hardware Store. Business in River Rouge thrived during those workers, companies like DTE, who brought their families here to shop on weekends. I loved growing up in River Rouge as a kid. My love for the city spurred me to run for mayor in 2005. It was a different time by then. Gone was a booming industry and bustling streets. I knew the residents and the children of River Rouge deserved more. My family love for Rouge spurred me to establish a nonprofit organization to help provide the charitable support for the children of River Rouge who were in need. We were able to work with DTE to secure the funds and guide the volunteers to activities to benefit the residents and the children in the town. DTE has always been a gorgeous and willing partner when it came to supporting the community in River Rouge. Some of the things that Trevor did already mention, No Kids Without a Christmas, coming out for the River Rouge Cleanup Day, help out to weed the flower plants in front of the City Hall, and preparing for the flower planting the next day. Both children and adults in River Rouge love looking forward in appreciation of the DTE float that participated each year in River Rouge Day's parade. But perhaps most important to the city and the residents, we enjoyed a special kind of relationship over the years with DTE plant workers and got to know the local business owners and develop a long-term friendship. So on behalf of the City of River Rouge, I'd like to thank DTE for their support over the years. We have enjoyed a wonderful and fulfilled partnership. We welcome you to come back and visit us with your families. And I'd like to say God bless and thank you so much.
That was actually here. You know, they really took the lead in doing so. No, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for the time being at Rouge. Taught me a lot. Grow as an adult, grow as an operator. I got all my license, for the most part, my second and first while being here. So I'm thankful to accomplish those things. And like I said, just look forward to what's ahead.
Well, hello, everybody, and good afternoon. Really great being with all of you all today. Before I get really deep into this, I want to take a minute to just thank everybody for being here, number one. But I want to thank a couple of folks in particular, because all the things that we're celebrating today, we certainly could not have done without our union partners. You know, we're a great company, and I've been here for about 2 years, and I have absolutely grown very appreciative of just the relationships we have. And I know, Jay Miller, you're here with us today, and I really appreciate it. You know, as many of you all have seen, as I've been listening today to everyone talk, what's coming through loud and clear is how much of a family River Rouge is and has been. That, in my mind, comes from a real caring respect for one another. I know that the past couple of years have been particularly difficult for this group, who has gone through a number of changes and working with a minimal crew, but you've always come through. You've finished strong, and most importantly, you've been able to do it safely. Working safely isn't new to this organization. As a matter of fact, in 2010, MIOSHA awarded River Rouge the Michigan Voluntary Protection Program, or MVPP, Rising Star Award for working the workplace safety and excellence. The following year, the plant was yet again recognized by MOSHA by receiving the Consultant Education and Training Division, or CET SET Platinum Award for its astounding, outstanding safety and health record. At that time, River Rouge had gone more than 6 years without a lost time accident and was the first power plant in Michigan to achieve Platinum Award status. As the plant retires, it has a record of going the last 3 years without a serious injury. Quite simply, that means each employee has been able to go home to their families the same way that they came to work, healthy and safe each and every day. And that is far more important than any award. So congratulations to you all, to all of you, and we'll give another round of applause. From my first town hall at River Rouge, I have come to know and appreciate the team's high level of pride. You have given hyper-focused attention to safety, finishing strong, and have adjusted through many challenges that have come your way. Following that town hall, I made a commitment that I would work on behalf of my coworkers to assure that their work in these plants was honored and appreciated as we continue to transition our fleet and retire more units. That's where Retire with Pride was born. You have every reason to be proud of yourselves and what you have achieved here. I know I am certainly proud of you, and I know that you will continue with the same passion and commitment as you take on your next assignments in the company. Thank you all, and thank you for servicing our customers with safety, care, dependability, and efficiency every day. So now is the time that we say goodbye to our old and trusted friend, the River Rouge Power Plant. I will turn it over to Nader Rajabian, the plant manager, who will power down the plant one last time. But before I do, I'd like to personally thank him for leading this team to this day. Mr. Nader.
Okay. Thank you, Ben, and hello, everyone. I hope you and your families are safe and well. Thank you for participating in this historic event for River Rouge Power Plant and DTE as a whole. Before we go to my section of our presentation, I want to take a minute to recognize Mr. Leonard Bonney and Ron Baker, our INC Tech. They are retiring effective tomorrow morning. Mr. Bonney retiring after 43 years, and then he worked at Monroe, Bear River, Heating Plant, Connors Creek, and River Rouge Power Plant. Mr. Ron Baker is retiring after 18 months working with us, but he has been in this business for the last 45 years. I appreciate their dedicated services to our plant and our company, and I wish them happy, healthy, and lengthy retirement. Today is really an appreciation day. I'm going to continue going on that route. I also want to thank and recognize the Retire with Pride Committee. They worked tirelessly to make this event to take place. In particular, Renee McLaughlin and Frank D'Angelo. They worked just around the clock to make sure this event goes flawlessly. Last but not least, I want to thank all the current employees, all the retirees, and support organization who made River Rouge Power Plant a wonderful place to work and excel. This afternoon, on behalf of all the employees, I have the honor to open a generator breaker on Unit 3 for the last time.